The hell? Okay, let's go. You know what, it doesn't matter because this is going to be a common save anyway. Got back to my settlement this afternoon and found a couple of settlers walking around the power armor. I was wondering how they did it because I would take all the fusion cores out of the armor.
Take good care of yourself.
Trying to find out, I ran fusion cores down to where they get just a little bit of charge on them, and I store them. And I was storing them in a box outside, and they were getting the fusion cores from there, stealing my damn power armor. Right there. Oh, there she is.
Busy day for you, isn't it? Well, it's about to get busier. You're going to lead this operation.
Damn straight I am.
What the hell is this operation about?
Hey, relax. We wouldn't send you off without the proper information. Recent events have upset our timetable. Getting the reactor online has become our number one priority. It needs to be running, well, yesterday. We're going to have to cut some corners. I'm not thrilled, but it means we'll need to rely on some pre-war tech. You're going to the Mass Fusion building to acquire a beryllium agitator for us.
And four.
What's a beryllium agitator?
The details would be lost on you.
Excuse me.
The point is, it'll allow us to boost the reactor's power and get it running sooner than planned. You just keep me safe. I'll worry about the agitator.
Sounds good. I'd appreciate the company.
Not as much as I'd appreciate coming back in one.
Stay ass here.
I don't
need
like going
you
above ground unless there's no other option. But here we are, with our options dwindling quickly. Not to put more pressure on you, but we have to move quickly on this. Word is that the Brotherhood is nosing around the area. We don't want them getting the agitator before we do. Head on up to the relay, and I'll meet you there.
All right, I'll be there in a minute. I gotta get my armor. That's in good shape. Yeah, that could, that's in okay shape. Yeah, I'm gonna have to go back. Sorry. Hey, it's Cookie! Don't yell at me either from in there. You wanna talk to me? Text, type. You know what? I'm gonna keep the honor. I'm gonna take the two arms. So. Ah, screw it. I wish they were XO1 pieces, but they're not. I don't think I can get them any stronger than that either. Model F. Yeah, Model Fs. Yep. A titanium plating. What is going on? Yeah, still got 22 people. But something done tripped my thing over here. The hell was it? A raider. Crap. Let me go help the visitor center. Damn, I never need this shit done. Take my leg off. Are you watching me cook? You just got me on as background noise. Like you said, I don't really care views of you, right? Oh, okay. Are you video chatting with your boyfriend? If you are, tell him to watch me too, because I'm awesome. Where are they? And his head is gone. That it? If they let me sleep in this house. Ah, damn it. Really? Ah, screw it. Shit, where's my damn place at? Damn, I didn't know it was that far. It's 9 o'clock in the morning, it looks like that. Oh, shut up. Yes, I'm great. Alright, where are we going? Oh, the elevator? Okie dokie. I don't understand why I gotta go to the relay when I got that relay. I guess it don't see me anywhere. Yeah, let's go. Yeah, whatever. Oh yeah, good. I was wondering if I put my power armor back on. Make my message to the Commonwealth today. I think I'm gonna go with a more sinister message.
Yeah! Brotherhood sure is here. Guess we'll have to go through them.
All right, let's go. This is what happens when you wait until you're level 140 before you do this. You're overpowered. Right here.
Nice.
my damn robot at? Oh, she was with me. Oh well. Okay. Oh God, no. Hey, my robot's back. Kinda caught up with me. Not her. And his head is gone. I don't know what that was, but okay. Alright, come on, let's go. No, you didn't. You're right there. And away we go.
solid for its time.
I don't know why you gotta be decontaminated before you go in there.
Decontamination complete. You may proceed.
Come on. Okay, let's go. I'm good. Let's go. Oops, hold on. Damn it. Serious members reduced, okay. Do I not have any in here? Carries wasn't it.
Yes.
Yep, sure do. Oh, where we going? Turned around. You're supposed to not be working, idiot. Where the hell is she at? All right, let's go. Let's go.
These guys just don't know when they're beaten, do they? I'll help the synths buy some time. Make sure you get back to the Institute with the agitator.
I'm not gonna let you have all the fun. how she beat me back to the Institute, but okay.
We don't usually welcome outsiders. I hope you can appreciate your good fortune.
Dr. Fillmore?
I think that was enough excitement for, well, ever. Thank you, really. Couldn't have managed it without you. I'll make sure the agitator gets where it needs to go. I understand Father is anxious to get you involved in something else. You'd better not keep him waiting.
Make you proud to see all that Father has done, all that he has built.
I see. You're sticking to the regimen?
Yes, Doctor. I'm taking all my little hits.
I see.
Yes, thank you.
I have to admit, a third generation sense of something.
You wanted to see me?
I understand mass fusion was a success, despite interference from the Brotherhood.
That's right. Thanks to me.
We handled them just fine.
That's what Dr. Fillmore reported. I'm quite pleased at the results. Would have been a terrible setback to lose that technology to those savages. The Brotherhood's intervention must be placed in a larger context, however, given their penchant for hoarding technology. Future conflict with them is guaranteed. We are, after all, keepers of the most advanced technology in the Commonwealth, if not beyond. It also cannot go unnoticed that there were concerns within the Institute about your allegiances. I, of course, never doubted your commitment to our cause. But by directly confronting the Brotherhood, I think you've put some others at ease. I'm proud of you. Regardless, the Brotherhood is an issue for the future, and we must focus on the present. And look at me, rambling on like the old man I am. I'm wasting time. You're needed elsewhere at once.
Do you need more parts for the reactor? I could have gotten them while I was out.
No, this is a different matter. Hopefully one that does not put anyone at risk. This situation, I'm afraid, is something of your creation, however unintentional.
What do you mean by that? What's happened?
Well, while you were assisting Dr. Fillmore, a second team was sent out to invite someone from the Commonwealth to join the Institute. Apparently, there was some miscommunication, and this individual called for help, which arrived in the form of your Minutemen. My understanding is that no shots have been fired. I would like it to stay that way. I need you to go there and speak to your Minutemen gathered outside. Insist that they stand down at once. Dr. Thompson is on site, and he will be your primary contact. I know you can resolve this situation, but it is of paramount importance that this special individual be brought to the Institute immediately.
They'll listen to me. I'll figure something out. You can consider this handled.
Believe me, I already do.
What's going on here?
You're an unexpected surprise. We could use the backup. These Institute bastards aren't getting away. They'll have to go through us to get out of there. We don't know quite what we're up against, but it's good you're here to help. How did you hear about this?
Can you bring me up to speed on the situation?
Commonwealth citizen lives in that there observatory. Institute thug showed up to haul him off, only he spotted him coming. He managed to fire off a flare gun, got our attention, and we got up here as quick as we could. Now they're trapped inside. So, how do you want to play this? We thought about trying to lure him out here, since it'd be easier to kill him. But then we realized we probably ought to storm the place, to make sure they can't disappear on us. That makes sense, right? So, you want to lead the charge?
What do you know about the person who lives here?
Not too much. Wallace is his name. Kind of an egghead type, but real squirrely. Keeps to himself. We've checked in on him every now and then, but he didn't seem to want the company. So, we moving in or what?
No one is going to do anything. Tell your men to stand down.
I don't... Are you...
You heard me, boy.
If we don't
stand
do
down.
Now, they're gonna take that poor guy wherever it is they go, and we'll have failed. Again, are you going to order the attack or not?
This whole thing is just a misunderstanding.
A misunderstanding? Can't wait to hear this. Explain to me how this.
I am superior officer. I don't have to explain it to you.
You don't have all the information. I do, and I'm telling you this isn't what it looks like. That man's not in danger.
You'd better be right. If you're not, that man's life is on your head. I'll have my men stand down, but you'd better get in there and make sure you're right.
Who do you think you're talking to? But you won't report.
Starting to worry we might not make it out of this mess.
Everything's taken care of. You're safe.
Good. Good. It was bad enough that Wallace started giving us trouble, but then he called in those savages.
The Minutemen were only doing what they felt was right.
Well, from here it looked like they were out for blood. And if you hadn't arrived, I think they might have gotten it. Can we just get on with this, please? I know he's potentially important to Phase 3 and all, but I'm not sure it's worth putting ourselves in harm's way.
If he's really important to the Institute, then it's worth it.
You're right, I suppose. I know they've been keeping an eye on him for years. Not sure how they originally found him, but probably don't want to know. But once they realized how smart he was and what an asset he could be for Phase 3, they watched pretty closely. I think they even fed him scientific material from time to time to see how good he was, you know, testing him to see if he was Institute material. Let's just get Wallace and get out of here.
No argument from me. Let's go.
Right. There's just, well, there's a slight problem with that. He doesn't want to go with us. I was thinking, maybe you could try and talk to him.
No problem. I'm sure I can get him to see reason.
I hope so. We really need him.
Mr. Wallace, I'm here to talk to you.
You're another one of them, aren't you? Are you a robot?
Please try and relax. I know this is an unusual situation.
No! You're here to kidnap me! That's what you people do, isn't it? If you even are people. I've heard all the stories. I know exactly what happens to people when the Institute shows up. Well, it's not happening to me.
Hey, hey, just calm down, okay? I just want to talk to you.
Fine, fine. What do you want from me?
The Institute needs your help, Mr. Wallace. It's as simple as that.
My help? With what?
The Institute has an engineering problem that your scientific expertise could help solve. In exchange for helping us out, you'd be granted access to the most advanced research facility imaginable. Whatever research you wanted to perform, anything, it's possible there. I promise. You'd be safe and secure in a way that's completely impossible anywhere else.
You'd be helping us create a better world.
That sounds good. Okay, fine. I'll go.
Okay. I think we've got this under control now. Thanks. I mean, thanks for the assist.
Hey, I'm here to help. You're welcome.
I really mean it.
You're damn right you do.
I'll see you back in the Institute.
Hey, Cookie, if this thing's lagging, let me know, okay? Because it looks fine from my end. Hey, that's fine. I mean, it's more delay. It should be more. It's typically more delayed through the Roku for some reason, but it may be more delayed through the laptop. It's basically because there's different processors processing it, and it's also probably arriving at different times. Like about a split second or so. As long as the game is lagging, that's what I'm talking about. Of course, there's going to be a delay in the you actually seeing me, because there's like a 30-second delay period in all streams, not just mine. Oh, God damn my arm. Crap. Oh, my arm. Oh, there I go, hurt my arm. Okay, let's go. Where's Father? Hey, you want to know something? They call him Father, but he's actually my son.
Express how pleased I am. Our new guest is familiarizing himself with his surroundings. Yet he's already pointed out several inefficiencies in our methods. With his help, Phase 3 will be ready in no time. And it's all thanks to you.
Okay, I understand what you're saying. I thought you was talking about your laptop was more delayed. I think, say, the TV, the Roku's a lot more delayed than the computer is. Probably because the computer's a lot more, I got a lot more powerful processor in it than the Roku does.
I hope you're not
one, and plus the Roku, you're on the laptop, you're actually seeing it on a web page coming from Twitch. On the Roku, it's got to go through that Roku app, which is a piece of shit.
I'm proud to help the Institute. Here's hoping it all pays off.
At this point, there is no doubt. It will succeed, and very shortly. There is one more part for you to play, and I think you might enjoy it.
Am I flipping the switch?
It is time to announce our
presence.
Oh yeah,
I'm
going to
enjoy this.
To request that they do not interfere with our plans. You should be the one to do it.
What kind of announcement are we talking about?
A broadcast. An announcement to the Commonwealth that the Institute is not to be trifled with. As the incoming director, that responsibility naturally falls to you. We've prepared some remarks for you to record. Once you're finished, we'll broadcast them to the entire Commonwealth. Use the microphone here and follow the script. It's quite simple. I'm sure you'll do fine, Mother.
For years now, you have suspected that the Institute still exists, that we are among you. It's true. But it's not the whole truth. We are here, and we are... in control. Our superior technology represents the future of the Commonwealth. Today, we activate our nuclear reactor, ensuring that we will persevere long after the world above ground ceases to exist. Ensuring that mankind has a future. We have no desire to interfere in the unimportant details of your... pointless struggles. We simply insist that you do not interfere with Institute operations. To do so would result in... your complete annihilation. Rest easy. Know that the future is... out of your control. And that mankind will thrive under our guidance.
Well, that was... interesting.
Damn straight it was.
Perhaps not what we originally intended. But it will certainly get your point across. Now it's
oh,
time
yeah.
to make sure that everyone hears it. How would you feel about making a little trip to
Sure,
Diamond
why not?
City?
I could use some fresh air.
A quaint phrase. Though I'm afraid the air there is anything but fresh. The radio station in Diamond City is listened to by many in the Commonwealth. if we'd like the people to hear what we have to say. It's the best way to reach them. Before we preempt their broadcast, we need to ensure it reaches the maximum range possible. I've been assured that the necessary parts are on site. You'll just need to install them to boost the broadcasting power. Report back when you're done. We should be ready by then.
Yeah, idiot, leave me alone.
Nice piece you got there.
Just keep the holes. You mean like this? That's what I thought. Okay. Tubes go here.
Okay. Let's try this.
I think the dials go here.
Maybe yep. This goes.
I haven't forgotten what you've
here.
Done for me.
Travis.
Things with Scarlet didn't really work out. But that's fine.
Okay, Travis Lonely Miles, I'll see you later. Got any good shit to steal? Oh. Okay. Either Travis is a freak or that girl left her clothes over.
Nice work bringing that rogue synth back.
Quentin is such a liar. How'd he know what the surface is like? He's never been up there.
Alright, let's flip the switch.
Enjoy your trip to the big
city.
It's done then? The transmitter has been modified.
It's ready.
Everything is in place. It's ready to go when we are.
Good. Once the reactor is online, we'll cut into their broadcast. I'll let you do the honors.
This, my friends, is the moment we've all worked towards. After all your effort, the time has finally come to start our reactor. No longer will we be forced to compromise to survive. No more will we need worry about outpacing our resources. My mother and I couldn't be more proud of what you have helped us accomplish. And we look forward to achieving even greater things in the future. The Institute is now truly mankind's best hope. Thank you. All of you.
Okay, this is my son, Cookie. And this is me.
Let your surroundings be a reminder of what science and willpower.
Sean.
It's almost hard to believe. After all those years of hard work, here we are. We've arrived.
We have arrived.
What you've made possible.
I did good work, didn't I?
Yes, I did.
Yes, you did. There's more work to be done before the Institute's future is guaranteed.
We got a couple of asses to kick.
The Directorate has convened a meeting about how to proceed. I'm not going to attend. You should be there as Director.
Oh man. I just want to see what's up here anyway. Oh please, people, move. Make a hole. Make a hole.
Latest synth generation is just amazing. Those guys in robotics are working miracles.
I'll just talk business. All right, you beat. Oh.
I'm happy to be here, Dr. Fillmore. I hope I do the position justice.
I'm sure you will.
Right now, we're all here because it's finally time to stand up for ourselves.
Let's not be dramatic, Justin. There's nothing dramatic about it. We're in a position to push back, to assert ourselves here. That's what we've
talked about
all along.
To bring you up to speed, obviously there are groups in the Commonwealth that stand in opposition to the Institute's goals. With the reactor now online, we have the ability to not only expand synth production, but to project power to a much greater degree.
Where are you going with this? What's the Institute's goal?
Well, the Directorate has agreed that steps must be taken to ensure our safety in the long run.
Let's just spit it out, shall we? The Directorate has decided that the Brotherhood of Steel need to be eliminated.
As the incoming Director, we felt it important to inform you of the decision and get your thoughts on it. So, where do you stand?
I agree. We hit them hard before they have time to react to our new position.
Good. That's just what I wanted to hear.
Shut up, Justin. You're on my shit list.
It's up to you and how we focus our efforts in achieving this goal. We'd like your input on what direction we should take. Do we increase synth production or focus on weapons development?
I've seen enough to know that weapons are the key to winning wars. Let's focus on weapons development.
As you wish. The advanced systems folks will get to work immediately. That's all we have for the moment. I believe Father wished to speak with you once our meeting concluded.
Father has always been unpredictable. I suppose his choice of a successor shouldn't surprise me.
I'm guessing he's down here.
The Institute is my life.
Damn it, I gotta kill Deacon. I don't want to do that.
Remember to practice good sanitation habits at all times.
Where the hell is he?
Several projects going right now, but
son.
One more should
be. Ah, there you are. You've met with the Directorate. I assume they made their intentions known? It was difficult for them to reach the decision to engage in open hostility.
I don't think it was that difficult.
What about you? You agree with their decision?
It's the only way we can ensure the Institute's safety. That makes it the right thing to do.
I'm glad you agree. None what comes next will be easy. That conviction may help keep us all going.
You know, Mother, it's no secret that you worked with the railroad in order to first reach the Institute. The depth of your involvement with them has been called into question repeatedly. I'm sure you can guess by whom. The question is, where do you stand with them now? Do you count them amongst your allies?
Does it even matter? What are you getting at?
I think it's obvious. For the Institute's position in the Commonwealth to be secure, the railroad must be eliminated. Completely. As our primary above-ground operative and someone who has had previous contact with the railroad, you are in the best position to carry this out. So what I'm getting at, simply, is this. Are you willing to destroy them?
There has to be another solution here. Something less violent.
I'm afraid the time for hesitation has passed. We must act decisively, and we must act now. Will you do it?
Is this really necessary?
I'm afraid it is. I take no pleasure in it, but it must be done. For the sake of everyone in the Institute. And it must be done now. Are you willing?
I can take care of them.
Good. Good.
I don't enjoy asking you to put yourself in harm's way, but this is so important.
Yeah.
Thank you.
a stranger ever comes up to you and gives you a back. Breaking Bear Hug? That's our runner. She practically worships you now.
Pam needs you in her room.
Oh, maybe I didn't have to kill Deacon. I hope not. He'll be pissed at me, though. Drummer boy dead. Thank you. Good grief. Screw it. Huh? Oh God, I've got to kill Deacon. Damn it. Shit. Oh, this is not going to be pleasant. Hello, hello, I am Patman. Or I'm Patman, excuse me. Right now I'm in the middle of the Institute ending. And I have to kill Deacon, which I don't want to. I hate the railroad, but I like Deacon. I'm good. Damn it, I hate to do that. Shit, I'm overburdened. I gave him stim packs. Forgot about that. Yeah, I started playing it the day it came out as well. And I played up until the point where I had to decide between the factions. And I just stayed there for a long time until I got up to, well, I'm up to level 142 now. So I went through all the DLC. And I just finished Far Harbor earlier this week, so I decided to start. Last night I played the, not before last, I played the Railroad ending. Tonight I'm going to play the Institute ending, and then I'm going to go back to a common save point and choose the Brotherhood ending. As soon as they announced the DLC was going up to $50, I immediately bought the DLC, and I'm glad I did. Just the first three DLCs alone is worth more than what I paid for it. Far Harbor was actually pretty good. It was long. It was a lot longer than I thought it was. The Automatron, however you pronounce it anyway, it was okay. That boss battle at the end was, you know, it was pretty rough. But I got through it, and then, like I said, Far Harbor was, there was a lot of stuff in there, but I finished Far Harbor, where everything worked out for everybody, so. If I can, I leave just as many factions alive as I can, you know, for one reason, and that's so I'll have, you know, plenty of vendors to go to. But the DLC I've got the most use out of was the Wasteland Workshop, which introduced, I think it's the one that introduced the concrete pieces, because I have built, I installed the fusion generators on all of my settlements, and then I immediately started scrapping all the wood houses and immediately replaced them with concrete houses. And most of them are a great deal of them, as I go through, are getting configured like this. I have the bedroom upstairs, living room downstairs, and then on the top floor I have the mall, which has all the shops and stuff in it. Whenever I get through the DLC next week, I will probably try to find a different game to play on a different day anyway, because I literally have a couple hundred games and most of them I haven't played. I'll catch them on sale, buy them, and that'll be the end of it. And I've literally had some for years. What version did you have it for? I mean, what system did you have it for when you had yours? Mine's on the Xbox right now. Stop listening. Yeah, that's one of the joys of having a Kinect. It listens to you. I thought about getting it for the PC, but according to the specs, it will not run on my computer. With my card, I have a 6870, I think. I'm planning on upgrading it shortly. I'm trying to wait till the RX 480s come out, because I'm an AMD fan, but believe it or not, I've tried it on my PC and it will run. You know, when I get into downtown Boston, it doesn't run well. I mean, it's got a lot of drop frames, but it will run. No, I downloaded a couple mods, I installed them just to try it, and then I immediately uninstalled them and went back to my base character because I wanted to try to keep it as pure as possible. And whenever I get done with all the DLC, I will probably install mods and have the modded character and play with it until some more DLC comes out, and then go back to my pure character because I love achievements. I don't know why I have to come and help these people. I changed their weapons out, so they're well armed and they got plenty of defenses. But if I don't come out here and help them, it'll fail just about every time. I've only had one time where it didn't fail. As of right now, there's 5 achievements I don't have. 3 of them I can't get until the DLC comes out next week. And the other 2 are the Institute ending and the Brotherhood ending. Once I have those 2, I'll have all I can get until next week. I put a lot of mods in my whatever it's called, the, they're not downloaded, but it's like saved or in your locker or whatever it is on Bethesda. And I only tried 2 mods so far. One of them was a jetpack. That was an infinite jetpack because I wanted to go to top of Mass Fusion Building. Of course, it broke the game when I done that. And then the other mod, see, I play as a female character, so I got a busty mod and tried it because, I don't know, I'm just that way, I guess. But when I start playing with mods, Anyway, one of the mods I'm definitely going to get, I want the modern day guns. I've seen them and they look awesome. And I'll probably get a mod for resources too, because I'm tired of farming those things. I'm hoping that I don't break my game because, it's not a mod, but it's kind of a glitch. You know, if you, you reach your maximum settlement building, you can like throw weapons on the ground and, you know, put them in the workshop and it'll like take it off. I've done that two or three times with Starlight Drive-In. I'm just hoping it don't break because that's my main settlement. So what other kind of games do you play?
And so, the work is done. I am sorry. I know it was likely difficult for you.
It was tough, yeah.
I assure you that there was no other way. Their fanaticism wouldn't have allowed it. There is obviously one final threat the Institute faces.
What is it? What's this last threat?
Well, perhaps it's not that obvious after all.
The Brotherhood
of Steel covets technology and has made it clear that we cannot peacefully coexist. They will eventually come for us and attempt to take what we've spent so long creating. We need to destroy them before they can destroy us.
Okay, Rainbow Six Siege, I've played Rainbow Six Vegas, and I liked it a lot. I mean, I loved it, but Rainbow Six Siege just didn't seem like my sort of thing. Battlefield, on the other hand, I have played every single Battlefield since Battlefield 1942, and I love Battlefield. The only one I have not played, but I do own, is Battlefield Hardline, and not gonna lie, I got really excited. I know I'm like an old man, but it brought out the teenager in me when I seen Battlefield 1, which is funny because I didn't start playing Battlefield 1942. Didn't come out till I was like 32 or something. But yeah, I'm a big Battlefield fan. I love Battlefield. I ain't worth a damn anymore on multiplayer because my reflexes have gotten too slow, but I do all right in the single player. Now, Battlefield 1942 and Battlefield 2, I actually got pretty good in multiplayer on doing that. And Ghost Recon Wildlands, that looks pretty sweet too. Not gonna lie. What's the last Ghost Recon? I think Ghost Recon Advanced War... No. Ghost Recon Advanced Warfighter. I'm not sure that's the last one I played or not. It was a long time ago. It may have been before that. It may have been a different title. But it was released not long after the Xbox... I think it was released in 06. It was not long after the Xbox 360 was released. I think that's the last Ghost Recon game I played, though.
Take the fight to them.
I'm glad you agree. But the problem with the Brotherhood of Steel goes beyond the edges of the Commonwealth. It's not enough to destroy them here.
There are more of them out in the world, Mother. And they too will come for us.
Yeah, there are a lot of good games. I'm actually torn. I love Battlefield. And I will get Battlefield 1. But I have been wanting to try Skyrim for a long time. I've never played any of those Elder Scrolls games, and I was debating on whether to do it because I know it's going to be a huge time sink. And then they announced the one for the Xbox One, so if I'm going to get it, I will probably end up getting that one. I'm not too much into the dragons and all that stuff, even though I played World of Warcraft for a long time. I really got burnt out on that. I ain't played in 2 or 3 years. But there's a lot of stuff coming out. I was excited for the Scorpio, and I was going to wait and just buy the Scorpio whenever it came out next year. And then they went and showed the Xbox One S, and I got to have it. I got to figure out some way. There's like $2,000 worth of stuff I want to buy this year, and I got to work my rear end off to get it, probably. I won't get it all, but I'll get some of it. The Xbox One S, I have a 4K TV, and I really... Wouldn't mind having that. Just for the 4K Blu-ray, if nothing else. Yeah, I know, it does look amazing. If I'm done with Fallout 4 by then, I'll probably take up Skyrim part-time and in Battlefield 1 the rest of the time. The single-player campaign on Battlefield 1 probably isn't going to be that long. Like I said, Skyrim is going to be a massive time sink. I've got probably 1,200 hours into Fallout 4. And I don't even know how many hours I got sunk into Fallout New Vegas and Fallout 3. It's probably twice that much.
You have something in mind if that happens?
I'd like to prevent it from happening in the first place. We will show them that if they interfere with us, the very technology they value so highly will be turned against them. We will teach them that we can appear at a moment's notice, wherever we please, and they cannot ever stop us. They will know better than to ever interfere with us again.
You seem pretty convinced this will work.
The Institute is nothing if not thorough. Dr. Watson should be in the lab. He will explain the details to you. Time is of the essence.
That's awesome. I'm not that hardcore into it as far as simulation. I'll go in there. I'm pretty much a lone wolf. I like sniping. I'll get in a position. I will hide and I will just sit there and snipe. That's why I like Battlefield 1942, because there's plenty of places to hide. And Battlefield 2, I forget what the name of the map is, but it's the one that's got the construction at one end of it, and the other end has some kind of a compound. And I used to get in that finished building and snipe people that would go over to the top of that television tower. And they'd peek over trying to snipe people, and I'd sit there and pick them off left and right. And I love claymores. I've got kicked more than a few times on servers because, I mean, I use claymores like they're supposed to be used. I put them behind me. As soon as they stuck their head up there, blew them off. Another game I'm excited for, even though it hasn't been announced yet, I'm waiting for the next Red. I love Grand Theft Auto. That's another game. That's another series I absolutely love. I own, between the Xbox and the PC, I own all of them. We're starting with one right on up to five. But Grand Theft Auto Online, I ain't really into, because I go out there and people just ride around killing you for no reason. I can't get nothing done, so I usually, if I play online, I usually go into a private server and just do single
surplus
missions.
Power should translate to increased efficiency and productivity.
But Red Dead Redemption, the next, whatever the next in that series is, I'm excited for it whenever it comes out. I played between Grand Theft Auto 4 and Grand Theft Auto 5. I played a lot of Red Dead Redemption. Also played a lot of Borderlands too. I finished Borderlands, and I got Borderlands the Handsome Collection, but I haven't started it yet. I got it a while back. I got, like I said, I have got so many games that the sad part is, with my health and stuff, I realize I am never going to live long enough to play them. I tell my kids that's their inheritance.
Dr. Watson?
Did you need something?
Any special projects going on that I should know about?
Are you referring to something in particular? Has something happened?
Sean says it's time.
Oh, well, I guess it's been coming. I suppose we should get moving. Let's go, Rosalind. Sean says it's time.
What now? I'm still working over the code that robotics sent over. The algorithm is a mess. It's not even close to peak efficiency.
I know, but we need to move quickly on this. Dr. Orman has done most of the hands-on work, so I'll let her explain the basics to you.
Strange thing about Red Dead, Red Dead Redemption, I'm not a big, Western fan, and I was surprised at how much I liked that game. I think I caught it on sale or something, like a Black Friday sale, and I, it was cheap, and so I got it, and I started playing, and actually, found out it looked pretty good, or it was actually pretty good.
About the airport.
Well, there are a few key buildings that are still structurally sound, but no pre-war aircraft are still in service. If they were a little less intelligent, we wouldn't even be talking about this. We'd have just swarmed them with synths. But they're not idiots. They've managed to generate an EM field that's messing with our ability to relay in.
Okay, Cookie. I'll see you in the morning then. Night. You ought to go wake your sister up and tell her to watch me, too. Cookie is my daughter. That's the reason she's one of the... I have a... Both my daughters that live with me are... I got them. Those are my only mods right now. And, yeah. She's, like, in the other room.
What sort of EM field? What's it doing?
Basically, just scattering any suitable complex signals, like the ones from our relay, preventing us from getting close. So the immediate area around their encampment is a no-go. They don't, however, have the entire airport covered. We can relay you in to a point at the edge of the airport, and then you can get in and take down the generators.
We'll have the element of surprise, if nothing else.
Exactly. You'll have surprise on your side. Should give you some time before they can organize a real defense. For every generator you take down, it means we can start relaying in synths, giving you even more of an advantage. And, oh, I almost forgot. Take these.
Oh, thanks. Grenades? Sure, I can always use grenades.
No, they're not grenades. This thing, and I haven't come up with a good name for it yet, it basically deploys a beacon marker. Wherever they land, we can lock onto them and relay synths directly to that position. If there's a hotspot, you can drop synths right on it.
Yeah, and they usually don't last too long either.
So put them to good use. Don't go tossing them into the bay.
What are these reinforcements supposed to do?
They're going to help you buy some time while you're completing the real objective. If nothing else, they'll take a few bullets meant for you. Your real job will be to reach Liberty Prime. You know the deal with that, right?
What's Liberty Prime?
Evan can give you the rundown.
Right? Sure. Liberty Prime was a pre-war experiment by the military. The Brotherhood found it when they moved to the Capital Wasteland. They never could get it up and running. Till they got help from Dr. Lee.
I didn't realize she'd had such an impact.
Yeah, it was successful enough that they brought it with them. You can guess, I think, who they plan on using it on next. Now, Dr. Lee had access to Liberty Prime. I mean, everything.
It's like the... I'm with that like I am about the survival. It's for some people, but it's not for me. I got this on very hard, and that's as high as I'm going. I love fast travel. I mean, I've walked all over the place anyway, but when I'm in a hurry, I just want to get there and,
capable of delivering the virus directly into Liberty Prime. The little guy is going to be exposed and vulnerable, so you'll have to keep an eye on him. Make sure he doesn't get shot,
Yeah, if I remember correctly, Liberty Prime didn't last too long in Fallout 3. I'm getting old, so I could my memory could be messed up, but I... Yeah.
I'm not boring you.
Actually, you are boring me. On our side,
that'll give us a hell of an advantage.
He's not going to go stomping around, and he won't be taking orders. But he will have his weapons and targeting systems overridden. And he'll absolutely recognize their airship as the primary communist target in the Commonwealth.
I'll tell you one thing I'm really disappointed with about Fallout 4 is no Three Dog. I was expecting him to be in it.
Position while the synth does his thing. Oh, and don't worry. We'll pull you out of there before everything explodes.
If you've got any questions, this is where you ought to ask. If not, they're probably ready for you upstairs.
I don't need no relay. I can get there anyway.
Have we got a plan B?
Seriously? No, this is it. Don't worry, it's going to work. If you've got any questions, this is where you ought to ask. If not, they're probably ready for you upstairs in the relay room.
What have I got for backup?
With our reactor online, once the field is down, we can throw everything we've got at them. And believe me, we will. If you've got any questions, this is where you ought to ask. If not, they're probably ready for you upstairs in the relay room.
No questions. Let's do this.
All right, good luck. I'll send word that you're on your way up.
Dr. Lee might not show it, but I can tell she's excited about having the reactor online.
Yeah, I know. I think that's the reason it didn't happen. I think this is just speculation. I'm guessing he was under an NDA and he said something he shouldn't have, and that's kind of what happened to Three Dog. Where the hell am I going? Oh, elevator. Oh, Travis, I don't blame you. I do too. Especially when back before I completed Confidence Man. That's the reason I believe that Three Dog was going to be in the game, and he spoke too soon and they dropped him because of it. Because the voice actor they got, whoever's doing Travis, I don't know if he's supposed to sound like that or what, but it's not very good. Here we go. Crap, I guess I should have went and got some, make sure my armor and everything was fixed. Oh well. So what's the most excited thing what's the one thing you're most excited for about E3, coming out of E3? Okay, what am I supposed to do? Thanks for the follow, Pat. I appreciate that. My next purchase is going to be a Bluetooth dongle, so I'm using these PX5 headphones for the Xbox, and I've got a just a... Damn it. Stop listening. Okay, and I got the, just a earbud in one ear so I can hear the computer. If I could get a Bluetooth dongle in that thing, it'll... In the computer, I can hear the sounds on the computer as well as the Xbox at the same time. Alright. Oh yeah, what am I supposed to do? Infiltrate the terminal. Okay. Shit. Crap. Well, this might be a little harder than I thought. Shit, they lighten me up. Yeah, I haven't played State of Decay. Like I said, unless I've basically in the last year, I started 2015 playing. I rebought Grand Theft Auto 5, so I played that whole campaign again. And then when I got done with that, I went into Borderlands, played that until. Pretty much from like July on to November, and then in November I started playing Fallout 4, and once I get stuck with a game I usually stick with it for a while, but I'm probably going to start, you know, streaming different games, like on at least once a week streaming something different just to keep from being too boring. That's what I like to see. I'll be honest with you about E3. One of the biggest surprises, and this is because I didn't read anything about a week before going into E3 because I thought, you know, everything's already out. All the rumors are already out there. And I already read them all. But apparently Sony said they wasn't going to say anything about the Neo, and I didn't know anything about it. And I watched that Sony press conference, and it was sad. I'm sorry. I don't really play most of those games. I mean, Resident Evil I played. And I'll be honest with you, I thought the Resident Evil was the new... They had decided to go ahead with the Silent Hills because I thought that's what it was, but... It does not look like a Resident Evil. Like I said, the other games, I haven't really played any. I have a PS4, but I don't really use it. My daughter uses it more than I do. But yeah, the most excited thing I was excited most for was Battlefield 1. Yep. There goes my legs. Shit, my robot's down. Yeah, I don't know why I was so excited for Silent Hill, because to be honest with you, I've never played a Silent Hill game. I think I may have played, you know, one level of like Silent Hill, the original back on PS1. I think that was it. And but I've seen them played before, and I really like the concept and everything, because I really like the Resident Evil. I played Resident Evil 1 and 2. I want to say I played 3 too. I haven't really played any Resident Evil since then. I've got the new Resident Evil HD, the remake, on my PS4, because that's one of the things that, you know, most things can be played either console or PC, whatever, but some things I believe should be played on a PlayStation, and Resident Evil's one of them. And to be honest with you, Tomb Raider's another one, because that's what I when I had a PS1 or the first PlayStation, when it came out, that's what I played on them, and I guess that's just stuck. There, maybe that'll turn them on there. I gotta get my robot. Oh, I forgot all about that. Yes, Uncharted. I played Uncharted 1, and I've really been kicking around the idea about getting the Nathan Drake collection. If I can find it at the right price, because I'll be honest with you, most of my games, with the exception of Grand Theft Auto and Fallout, I usually don't pay full price for them. I catch them on sale somewhere, because I'm a cheap old bastard. But yes, I've been honestly thinking about getting Uncharted, the Nathan Drake collection, replaying 1 and then playing 2 and 3. And then later on, maybe it'll be, you know, I'll catch it on sale and get number 4. But yeah, I really liked Uncharted. Shit, where am I supposed to be going anyway? Holy shit. I'm guessing these people are just going to keep respawning. Hey, they still got some DLC to release. They may show up after, you know. They may show up later on. I don't want to spoil anything for you because I think you haven't played the Far Harbor DLC, but there is an Enclave soldier in it. I mean, you don't know it unless you carry on a conversation. That's all I'm gonna say. Is he representing the Enclave? No. But he was a former Enclave soldier. So hopefully the Enclave will come back. I do. I agree. I wish they were in it too. Should have killed that thing when I had the chance. Am I not hitting him? I just killed somebody. To him. I was one of my favorite vendors. Shit, I might as well take off the damn armor. It ain't doing me much good. But the head's still highlighting stuff, so I guess it is doing some good.
Sensors indicating concealed organic life form.
Oh shit. I just shot one of them in the head. Boom, in the back of the head.
No.
shit, my settlers are helping me. I'll be damned.
Is someone present?
Where is it? My favorite companion? I use a robot now for one reason and one reason only. Is because I've got it to where I can drink and take all the drugs I want and it doesn't affect me. But my favorite companion is Kate, hands down. And after, well, she doesn't like me doing drugs anymore. I should put it that way. My three favorite companions in order are Kate, Nick Valentine, and Deacon. Alright, where is that other one at? Yeah, Kiri's pretty good too. The one that I hate the most, this comes as no surprise probably, and that is Preston. I went through all the companions though, and I maxed all of them out. But I only romanced the females because I'm a dude. This is what I like.
Overactive sensors. Nothing more.
All right, what am I supposed to be doing? Okay. My damn robot go to. Good, my settlers are helping me. Oh my god, I can't stand the Minuteman either. I couldn't stand the railroad either. Yeah, I maxed all the relationships. I just didn't romance the males. I just romanced the females. But I got all the perks. I don't mind shooting that smart ass.
Oh,
Sorry, Brandis. Should have stayed in that, bunker you were in. God damn it, did it again. Did that. That is what I wanted. I sure am glad I armed all my settlers really well, because apparently they're helping me. Okay, time for me to leave, I guess. Is there any specific place I'm supposed to go? Okay. That was that. Oh, there's my robot. Yeah, I know that's the one I'm doing now. And And when I'm done with all three endings, what I'm going to do, unless I can figure out how to get the Minuteman ending, I'll do that one too. But I'm going to go back to my common save point, and I'm just going to keep it there because, to be honest with you, I like being on the same side as all four factions because I have a bunch of different... I like the Minutemen for their artillery. I like the Brotherhood of Steel for their... vendors and their vertibirds. I like the Institute because it's just cool. I just really like the Institute. Though I had a specific reason for the Institute. Railroad, I couldn't give a shit less about, except for Deacon. That's the only thing I like about the Railroad. And that is it. Have you seen the preview for the DLC that's coming out next week? The attractions? Yeah, I kind of figured that. Need some more drugs. £1, really? Okay, well, I ain't gonna say nothing else. I don't want to spoil it for you.
You wouldn't be here if it weren't a success. I'm glad it worked, but I'm glad you're safe.
We're all safe now.
For now, yes, but there will always
be threats. Is she on top of his bed?
You must remain vigilant. Ali has always
been to the Institute. Basically, and to the in the DLC that's coming out next week, the Contraptions Workshop. Basically, one of the things you can do is, I don't know if you know what stocks is. It's basically where it's an old form of punishment where you have somebody in the town square and have their hands and head in basically a wooden stock. And whenever I get that, I'm going to put the first one. The person I'm putting in there is Preston. I'm going to learn him to send me on a bunch of bullshit missions.
You can rely on her for help. Once I'm gone, it's all up to you.
In the announcement, when they brought it, when they announced it, they had Mama Murphy in it. I thought that was funny.
I know you will. Don't worry about me. You need to look ahead.
The missions would have been fine if they'd give me more than just a little bit of XP, but the amount of XP and the monotony involved was just ridiculous.
I was wondering what you were like. Thinking about all we missed out on, I want you to know that I'm grateful for the time we've had.
The First thing I did, one, I stopped going around Preston as much as possible, because every time I would get within range of him, he'd say something and automatically, boom, I got a mission. And then the castle radio, I turned the speakers off. So if I'm there,
this really is a matter.
They can't, if you don't hear it, they can't, it won't pop up as a mission. But if that speaker's going and something comes through, it'll pop up as a mission.
I'm glad I found you.
As am I. Thank you.
All right, hurry up and die already.
You've helped a boy achieve his dreams, I think. I think I'd like to sleep now.
There you go. Go ahead and take that dirt nap.
I've lost Sean. All over again. I close my eyes. I see my life before all of this. Before the bombs. Everything can change in an instant. And the future you plan for yourself shifts. Whether or not you're ready. At some point, it happens to all of us. This was not the world I wanted, but it was the one I found myself in. The Commonwealth. My home. Ripped apart and put back together. I thought I hoped I could find my family. Cheat time, make us whole again. The way we were. But now I know. I know I can't go back. I know the world has changed. But the road ahead will be hard. This time I'm ready. Because I know war. War never changes.
It was Cosworth. Wadsworth was your companion in your robot companion. Well, it wasn't companion, it was just a butler in Tenpenny Tower in Fallout 3. Codsworth is the robot butler in Fallout 4. Okay, that's strange. Okay, I guess that's it. Alright, well, I guess that's going to do it for me tonight. It took me like 6 hours to finish the railroad playthrough, and it only took me like 3 hours to do this one. Unless something happens, I'll be back tomorrow night to do the Brotherhood playthrough. Like I said, thanks for the follow, and if you ever want to check me out on Xbox Live, here is my gamer tag. If I'm ever doing any multiplayer games, I wouldn't mind joining them, but, as far as, parties, I'll join a party too if I can get my, like I said, if I can get my headset working, because, except streaming, when I'm streaming, I usually try to keep my Xbox offline, so I don't get any requests or anything, but, if you ever see me online, just, you know, say hey or whatever. And like I said, unless something unforeseen happens, I'll be back tomorrow. And I appreciate the follow, and I appreciate you being here watching it with me. And you have a good night.